Hello viewers, last day I discussed about the open loop and closed loop system. Today I will discuss about the transfer function. Basically, in a control system, transfer function is very important one. So what do you mean by transfer function? Transfer function of a system is defined as the Laplace transform of output by Laplace transform of input with initial conditions zero. So for a system, why we are calculating transfer function? Because from transfer function I can check the stability of the system. Okay, how I can check that? Easily, from a system I can generate transfer function. If I can generate transfer function, from there I can understand the closed loop system characteristics equation, and from that characteristics equation I can calculate the poles, and from the transfer function actually I can calculate poles and zeros. So poles and zeros are very important to check the stability of the control system. So transfer function, basically I will use transfer function in the first one, I will use it for the block diagram. Now what do you mean by a block? A block is actually, you can say, a block has some particular input. Let the particular input is x and particular output is y. So what is the transfer function of this? I can say ys by xs is equal to whatever gain is there, that is this ys by xs is g. So a block mean, a block consists of a system, right? A system mean it may be mechanical system, may be electrical, may be non-electrical system. So a block will consider, in the block diagram method we will consider only a block, will not think about the circuitry between them. Okay, so only the block. So where the block diagram is used, and so this is the transfer function. Transfer function mean output by input. So each and every block will have some input and some output. So a block is defined by output by input. So why it is needed in control system, why block diagram is it needed? Suppose I have a system like this. Okay, so what it mean? Suppose, why it is needed? So from this diagram I can understand, if I am giving some input here, I am getting some output, how I will calculate the output by input? It will not very easy to calculate output, overall output by input. If the system is like this, system is like this mean G1 is our one block, G2 is another block. That mean the G1 block has some output, this will go to the G2 block, and from this G3 block. So if I can say, it may be like this, it may be plus, okay, it is plus. So the part of this input is coming with this multiplication with this gain, coming here, and this will be there. So the, if the system is complicated like this way, there we'll use the block diagram. So block diagram, after block diagram reduction, we'll get the overall transfer function. That means y by x I can calculate if I maintain some rules. So block diagram has some definite rules. So in the next lecture I'll discuss some rules of block diagram, how I can solve the, by the method of block diagram, how I can get the overall transfer function from a system.